you know, Quirkfu at least tells the salve in a full tango, but.
Yeah, plus, Boogie can just, like, roam right back. Oh.
Or.
That was risky.
He was looking for DK Phobos. Does he have Rolling Boulder? He already used it. Shrine comes out. Boogie is maybe dead. Yeah, they're going to go for the Primal Spring. Boogie gets hit by it. One more auto attack from DK Phobos. We get First Blood. And now they're chasing after Hani. He's like, why did you involve me in this? Get me out of here. He has the Wind Lace. FNG has another Tree Dance and Primal Spring in about 5 seconds.
They can, yeah.
Stormhammer comes out. No Soul Assumption, though, mind you. But here's the Rolling Boulder. Boogie rotating back in. FNG chasing too far. Now DK Phobos getting caught by the Grave Chill. Still no Soul Assumption. He's so close. He just needs one creep. Yeah, I prefer
unnecessary, but smart.
I prefer the tree, to be honest with you, but the minimap works just as well.
It's so slow. The 200 move speed.
Yeah. So I guess it's based off of what you change into?
Yeah, certain ones have different move speeds.
The courier's faster. Yeah. Rolling Boulder. Iceberg's going to get pushed back. TPs are coming in. We should have some damage here. Already a Scuba Pain coming out. Soul Assumption. The stun coming in from FNG. One more auto attack. The deny is there from Thanksgore. Oh, man. And they even get the clumps back as well, but Quirkfu should be fine. They even 6-3-3
right on. Yeah, they also have the Omni Slash just kind of ready too, but bottom lane seems like they're pinging. They seem to know that DK Phobos is in here.
Yeah, Boogie's setting up for nearby. The courier is trying to bring him something.
Alright, well now they definitely know.
They definitely know. Grave Chill will come out, but here's the Firefly. Hani needs to be careful. Rolling Boulder in. Should hit. Actually gets dodged. Boulder Smash will. Stormhammer
nice
coming out. He wants to get to
the
high ground. Soul Assumption. They need one more auto attack. The Fairy Fire is there. He gets the kill on Hani, and he might make it out of here. He's very speedy with his Wind Lace and Tranquils. Still, they need another Rolling Boulder or something. They have one in Boogie, and he's going to go for it. You might find him. DK Phobo is still stuck in the tree lines here. Stormhammer will come out. He did get the kill on Hani. Boogie starting to burn down, but he should be okay. But not that bad for DK Phobos, but it's still a spree going to era at the very least.
Yeah, that was close to being it.
A lot of heroes have rotated in from Team Spirit. They even dropped a couple of wards down. Sentries placed. Some very good vision advantage here in the mid lane. But the Rolling Boulder in. Iceberg jumped in, coming out from FNG. Sonic Wave blows up one. Can they get two? Good stun, but he still might fall. Boogie gets the last auto attack. And well, NIP, Boogie and Quirkfu together just owning.
Risky farming by DK Phobos.
Yeah,
he's gonna get caught out.
He's gonna find him. Should have Boulder Smash ready and Rolling Boulder. Shadow Strike comes out. DK Phobos, I believe you are dead, my friend. That Flame Break, while solid, is not going to save your life.
Yeah, Trixie, smart play by Boogie, too. He was just
runs in and he's just like, guys, I'm
he's
here.
A little late.
All right, chill.
It was good job holding the stun, too, right? Because if he just, you know, if you panic a little bit there and you see this bat right and you just kick it right away, he could have just TP'd out because they are lacking cancels. In this game from a couple of their heroes.
They're playing pretty smart with the ability. Boogie, by the way, is having a great game. I mean, Earth Spirit, pretty fun hero to play, pretty good hero to play, and it's going to find another kill here as the Silence comes out. The Soul Assumption is there to secure the kill for Hani to get him back on the board. Hani is poor.
Inside the Static Storm, perhaps, might be one way to get him. So,
or they could just all rotate up. Comes back in, Kinetic Field is there, Aerith somehow makes it out, Stormhammer, oh, Banksport, you don't want to be here. They avoid the stun, oh, the Warcry comes out as well, FNG has to head into the trees, the Iron Shell is still there. BZZ, he will pop the Omni Slash, Trixie actually taking the majority of that damage, if Aerith could survive, this would be huge. Sonic Wave comes out, one more auto attack, no, BZZ somehow still alive, and Quirkfu trying to chase it down, the Scream is not there in time. Oh man, Quirkfu was so close, now he'll chase after DK Phobos, Shadow Strike. Already used, Scream of Pain will come out as well. He'll blink away. FNG, somehow, they turn that around. They get two kills. They will only lose one on the side of Spirit, I believe. Oh, man, he was one more auto attack away. One more.
Yeah, that was tough. I was actually unintentionally watching that whole fight from Radiant Vision. I just happened to have it toggled on when it started, and that was just they actually could not find the jug once he was out of the kinetic field.
Yeah. He just got Radiant's destroyed. And I think despite how much, you know, hold that. Oh, FNG, buddy. You're dead. Magnetized, TP canceled, Boogie will take the tower hit. But I think Era, despite that fight, is still... I mean, we saw how strong he is.
Boogie is fresh out of resources at this point, though.
You need to leave. Comes back. I think that's on the Hani. Now God Strength will come through FNG. Oh, he's like, please, no. Static Storm, he gets out of it. One more auto attack. They missed the stun again onto Era. Bank score now is... probably dead, but maybe not. Here comes the Omni Slash, the bird soaking a lot of it up. Era, the lasso is there, and it looks like he might fall twice. The assassinate will come out. The war cry is there. They've lost two already, including Boogie. They lose the Disruptor finally on the back lines here, but still, getting that kill on Era is absolutely gigantic every time they can get it. And Team Spirit do it again as they all rotate in to stop that fight going in IP's way.
Yeah, that's a lot of gold heading towards our Juggernaut. Grab ourselves a good kill.
This should be somebody, whether it's
going to
be
no
Era.
Vision
oh
here.
Man, Era would be the perfect target. Blink, Firefly, Warcry is there. They've got the last, so TP's need to come in and they need fast TP's. But there's the Static Storm. He has wand charges. He has his armlet toggle up. The Glimpse back in as well. The stun comes out. They bring him down. But how much are you going to lose for this if you're Team Spirit? So far, nobody yet. Here comes Iceberg. Popping people from the back lines. Back wall to come in. The Magnetize on top still. Trixie is low. Boogie chasing after Iceberg. He wants to skill. Sonic Wave will grab a kill for Quake, but still it's a double. And Vanctuar about to fall as Hani now going to work on the back lines. Still jumping in. That Shrine for BZZ might help him out a ton. Quake and Boogie now have it heading away. They have the Omni Slash coming out. Boogie will fall. Good thing he didn't jump to Koikfa because then he just blinks away. Meanwhile, Hani and Koikfa find that third kill, and it turns into a 3-for-3 fight when it's all said and done because Koikfa is able to get in there and get out rather quickly. And, well, that was a lot better than it could have been for an IP. They have the Static Storm for counter initiation, but Vanctuar is just TPing. They get the silence now on BZZ as well. DK Fobo is somehow still alive. The Rolling Boulder, the blink out. Is he going to make it away?
Wow.
It looks like no. Yes, Era gets the kill. The birds were following him. They actually do bring him down with the help of Era. And BZZ didn't get chased down. They decided, okay, let's kill the Batrider first before we make any other aggressive play.
Yeah. Like, just the efficiency that teams are so used to. But Quickfist's going to lead off. He's under
his Invis rune. They're going to clip some back. Static Storm is going to be there. He's going to get caught. Quickfist, Mech is going to go through, but the Blade Fury is up, and he will fall. They're going to take this fight anyways, though. They'll blow up the Sniper. Vacuum Wall with the Boulder Smash. The Omni Slash is there as well. They need this Fen to get in. They should have some right click here. FNG getting chased down. Era needs two more auto attacks. The game is actually lagging while this is happening. Double kill comes through as well. Now Hani's starting to go to work. You're lagging too, right? It's not just me.
Not where I was looking in the fight, but
oh man, this was
normal.
It was the type of lag that happened the other day, where like that was a constant like frame stutter. Meanwhile,
oh yeah,
Boogie
that
gets
weird
blasted
server
up,
leg.
Forced back, Rolling Boulder out, but right into DK Phobos. I don't know about this fight. Boogie still might actually get killed here, but it's a bit dangerous. Still though, I think it's a 3-for-3 when it's all said and done, and Iceberg continues to get owned. Tier two. I don't think they should have seen this. God's Strength's gonna go. They're gonna go for the Blink Stun. BZZ gonna be caught now. The Boulder Smash comes out as well. They need this kill. Now they need one more auto attack. The spin comes out, but Era is there. The tower will be taken at the very least. Vacuum almost catching out FNG, but he makes it away with the Primal Spring with the Tree Dance. And Quake was still chasing Blink. There's the Orchid. Now the Shadow Strike to come out as well. I'm not sure if he can really make it through. They have the Surge up, the Iron Shell on top, and a couple more auto attacks, which should bring FNG down. So they lose the Tier 2 tower, but finally, BZZ goes down for the first time in the game. And it is to the hands of Era that does so. Which means that Roche is now wide open if they want to go for something here. Psychological thing too, kind of, you know.
Dude, DK Phobos is in here deep. He sees one TP coming.
Wow, he really is. He's going to find the lasso. Trixie's going to get caught. Static Storm, Omni Slash. Greaves will come out. They threw a lot there. Now Era's going to jump in, but actually he's going to get clips back. He pops the BKB, however. And looks
like a Lincoln, so you could just go double defensive.
Right. I wouldn't be surprised to see either. But the way this game has gone, I think it will probably be Scythe. We'll see anyway.
I kind of like the Lincoln, so I'm not sure how much Scythe is going to benefit him, honestly. Like, maybe Scythe, I suppose, but.
And that's the Monkey King again. Just the vision that you get from jumping out of trees. So he got a little aggressive, and FNG will make him pay. They will take the Tier 2 tower. There's one Tier 2 tower left mid. Vanxcore, though, going to try for Glimpse mid. Static Storm comes out. He'll pop the BKB. He's forced to use it. Vanxcore probably is going to die from this. Stormhammer comes out. BZZ in the tree line. He has on.
They know he's there.
Six.
Oh,
they're going to back right through. Meanwhile, they're going to come in with the tree. Primal Spring. They stun Trixie again. The Omni Slash is there. They pop the Warcry. The Monkey King ult is going to come out as well. The back wall. Sonic Wave coming through. FNG should fall. Era now trying to fight. Still has that Aegis. BKB's there looking for Iceberg. The auto attacks almost bringing down BZZ with the Echo Saber. Scream of Pain will hit up onto Iceberg. Quake has another blink in 2 seconds. Instead, they're going to try to go for DK Phobos here, but BKB will get popped from him. And now, auto attacks onto Era doing some serious work coming out from the Sniper. And Iceberg is still on the low ground. Soul Assumption, he's able to blink away. They actually get the kill onto Koikfa as well. He stays around a bit too long. And all of a sudden, an IP, not the best fight in the world for them.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Era might get caught here. This is troublesome. BZZ man fighting. Good griefs coming out. Era still will fall. That's just the Aegis as BKB is back up in 5. Meanwhile, they get the kill on the Batrider. Static Storm comes out. He's pretty tanky. BZZ is going to work the BKB forced to pop. They're going to try to turn this around. The Soul Assumption. They have this done. And the God Strength coming out. But the evasion is there. The Blade Fury is up. They have the Glimmer Cape. Do they have detection? It looks like no. The Assassinate brings Era down. Boogie wants this kill, but he can't get it on his own. And BZZ is so damn fast with that flutter. And it looks
reason. Much I don't know. The blue one was a little much, to be fair.
Really? You think so? Was it that bad?
I think it was a little much.
All right. I
like, why couldn't they have just made it cool with, like, I don't know.
Well,
it was a long time for a second blue hero Arcana.
Yeah, that's
exactly
true.
Like
that
PA
is a good
one.
Point. That is, I think,
the classic.
Yep, indeed.
New cool kid Sven built.
Oh boy. Thanks, Gore. I believe you are dead. See you later. He has no buyback either, so they have to go on. Based under siege from some illusions and the creep wave. He's going to respawn. We'll find out in about 20 seconds or so what the actual respawn timer is. Might be a long one. We'll see. But I don't know. I feel like NIP is still in a very good position. I feel like Iceberg hasn't contributed that much. Rolling Boulder comes out, blink forward, he's been caught, he might be caught and killed yet again. He's gonna try to force himself away. They have some way of stopping this, yes. TP is gonna be canceled by the familiars, and a nice big pickoff there to bring down their second most farm hero. And that might lead into some mistakes here, but we'll see.
Oh, they see Hani.
War versus five, if they wanna go for
dude,
this,
this is
a bit dangerous.
This is a bait.
Now they're gonna God's Twin jump in, vacuum wall coming out, the Hex is there. BZZ blown away, the Static Storm comes in, but it's too late. Thanks for trying for the TP, he might actually make it out and have a way to stun him as Boogie was still caught in the kinetic field at the end of it. FNG is on the tree line, but they back up together.
Oh, they saw Sven.
Yeah, Sven has been seen. Everybody trying to TP, Vanscore probably is gonna be the lone, lone death.
God. Look at that damage.
Yeah, that wasn't fun. That was not fun. This is just a Shiva's and 3.4k gold. Buy a Deso, man. Do it again.
Dude, look at that minus 30 second respawn time, though. Level 16, and he's back in 10 seconds.
Oh, he's so far stayed in them. He will get out. Illusions will be cleared up by
Look at these illusions. Bottom.
They are crushing him. His mana is gone. He is to Creeps. There's the Abyssal though. Oh, TK Phobos might be in trouble. BKB's forced. Rolling Boulder comes out. Slowed up. Dead. 20 of damage.
Wow, he has no buyback.
Yep. 81
and
seconds
Jug
on
also
the sideline.
Just spent out too.
Roche is back up and pretty much right now if they wanted to go for it. But instead, I think they want to try to. Sniper's not, however. Rolling Boulder. They're trying to find FNG. Now BZZ jumping in. Era goes to work. That melee rax is gone. Stun will come out. Static Storm. Meanwhile, there's no BKB because of that Static Storm Ags. The Omni Slash jumping as well. Koifa is in trouble. He needs to leave the Assassinate coming out, but he gets disjointed by that blink just narrowly. Now the Abyssal coming in, the Grief. They're going to try to turn this around. Sonic Wave coming through. They get the Hex up, but here's Wukong's command. Good Boulder Smash. Soul Assumption. The right click damage is there. The Glimmer Cape comes out, and Koifa won't chase any further into the tree line. Meanwhile, Koifa walks into the Bastion of the Wukong's command. The glimpse back out will be there. The Kinetic Field, the stun on top. Another right click Soul Assumption coming through, and Koifa will fall. And NIP do not expect that agony except from Team Spirit. And now they need to leave. Hani Glimmer Cape will come through. He's got the gem, mind you. The kinetic field is up, and he will fall as well. Drop to the deck. A triple kill for Iceberg. There has not been a bigger time for that agony except to come out. What's happening?
Stupid tree, dude. This monkey kick.
Oh, his monkey
I was just like looking at the screen, and this tree just starts moving.
It's spin from BZZ. The right clicks. Now the Wukong's command. They've lost the Earth Spirit. Shrine will come out. They really don't want to have to use this point for buyback, but now it still might be some trouble. BZZ, they're going to jump in. Era stuns, but he gets bashed up by the Wukong's command. The cheese will come out. BZZ's low, but Era needs to back up and away. Now Hani's coming in with the right clicks. He's doing some serious work. Still, they're going to find Boogie first as he buys back and dies. BZZ, the tower hits aren't going to be enough. Koifa is alive in 5. They've also lost Hani. And all of a sudden, this is going to have to be 4 versus 5 defense now that the dieback is there. Onto the Earth Spirit. This melee rax might fall. Jump in, back wall coming out, nicely done. They get the Static Storm to come up and follow up, but still, Sonic Wave blowing up two, including Iceberg. He's got buyback. The Hex is there. They will lose another. It's going to be FNG falling as Koyfa gets the double. The Abyssal Blade comes out. BZZ trying to run. Spin is there. Koyfa's going to chase after him. The Glimmer Cape is up. The Omni Slash will come through. Koyfa gets bashed, but he should have buyback even if he dies here, and he won't make it down either. The Storm Hammer coming out, stunning up nobody. Now DK Football's trying to run with BZZ. They will both make Tinker Ward here. BZZ would be there's no reason
that's
for that.
That's a good point, actually. Well, they've been pretty good at the Tinker Wards, honestly. They've been putting down, like, in their other games we were watching, they were putting a lot of them down versus these kind of split-pushing heroes. And all right, well, Monkey dies.
Ooh. Yeah, gotten two-shot by
that movement, too, and now we got another smoke coming out here.
Look at this play, though.
Look at this Monkey go, dude.
Yeah, they're going to see some stuff happening. Cloud. The sun comes out. The static storm is there. Quake was going to get caught. The Omni Slash going. The Abyssal on top of it. The Assassinate. Oh. He won't make it away. They blow him away. Good magnetize. The stun into two from Boogie. They're trying to chase further. DK Phobos trying to find something. Iceberg will take down Boogie. It's two dead all of a sudden now. Arrow chasing after BZZ. The Abyssal comes out, but the evasion is there. The Storm Hammer. BKB pops. He's got buyback. He might need to use it. It's going to be the Primal Spring coming up from FNG looking for Hani, but he's pretty tanky. Glimmer Cape comes out now. Iceberg almost going to get two-shot, and he will.
Oh my god, the Iron Shell.
They're owning. FNG now silenced up as well. They need an auto-attack. They get the Storm Hammer, the Glimpse back, but he gets the kill. And so Trixie finds double. And now Arrow's looking for more. He's looking for blood. Storm Hammer is up. DK Phobos, but he gets stunned as the Lotus Storm is now up. Jug buys back. Vacuum Wall coming in. Vank score should fall to this potentially. The Thunder Strike as well. Trixie getting a triple kill now. And now Orchid comes out. Stormhammer is there as well. Era has got the Abyssal Blade. He actually gets used on it by BZZ. BZZ is going to fall. The Ultra Kill. Trixie turns it around. It's a dieback. And now they finally get Iceberg back into the game. And that might be enough to slow things down here as Era will fall. And Trixie finally going to get pushed back as well. The Lasso, they'll lasso each other, but the Assassinate. And just because they keep them in place, they get Iceberg a double kill. So even though they lose BZZ twice, the game is still alive for Team Spirit.
Oh, three heroes occupied with stuns and kicks and magnetizes over here, which is what let them chase down BZZ in the first place to get that kill, and then subsequently the sniper thereafter.
DK Phobos, I don't know about this play. I guess there's not much else he can do. He doesn't have a TP, so he knows he's dead. And, he does have buyback, but I mean, that's not what you want to do. And guess what? That gives Boogie his Aghanim Scepter. So, that's a big
remnant,
baby.
Aghanim's ages.
Careful, Koyfa as well, but they're sitting in the trees now. The scan is successful. Aaron's sitting on the higher ground. There's the Sheep's
Guard. Oh my god,
he's
going right past
the sword.
There's
going to be the lasso. No, he breaks it. The Lincoln Sphere, he wasn't expecting it. DK Phobos now. Lasso is down. BKB is forced. They get Iceberg stunned up as well. They're going to try to find something. Good Static Storm into stun. Vacuum Wall. Wukong Command is up. So far, not the best fight. All of a sudden, Spirit turning around. They take two. They're going to get Arrow as well. The cheese was up and ready. Koyfa might have to buy a bag, but all four are dead right now. They won't have air respawn, but the Monkey King going to work. The Static Storm was there. It's a triple kill for Iceberg. How did that fight go the way it went? I don't know.
And score and FNG. Wow.
What gods.
I mean, you didn't have to do anything as the rest of the heroes. You know what I mean? Like, that fight was just over.
Hit R button.
Three-man Static Storm to start it off, and then right into the Monkey King ult. The bashes were flying everywhere. Koyfa got obliterated. I mean, this guy has an AC, and there's a war cry from a Sven. Oh, and they got wrecked.
Monkey King just needs one good ult and, like, one good stun. And the game is now pretty good for Spirit. Like, that was...
Question is, can they do anything with it? Oh, my God. DK Volus, he's so close when he goes to these attempts.
I'm also
bringing... He is caught.
Stun. Boogie is done. See you later. Now it's 4 versus 5 for 85 seconds. That's all it takes. That is all that it takes. And also, again, have been kind of insane. You know, they've been pretty ridiculously good.
Oh, they're Fireflying again. Now, this is definitely scouted, obviously. He's going past
they're
everything.
Jumping in. They get the back wall, but it's only on Iceberg. And now, all of a sudden, this could be problematic.
He's
Iceberg
still alive.
Low, but still alive. They're going to get the double last one from the air, perhaps, here. They get the Abyssal Blade coming through. It's the Lotus Storm, though, that stuns for both. Now, they get off the Hex onto BZZ. Kinetic Field is up.
Oh, that's
now
no
they need
buyback.
To be careful. They can't afford to lose air here. He will fall down for 2 minutes. And all of a sudden, this turns so bad for an IP. They're going to lose Koyfa as well. He's got buyback, but there's only three heroes left at this point. Trixie and Hani are on the run. The struggle. They need to be getting back, I think, at this point.
Are they noticing?
I don't know. They're just hitting the racks. They need to leave. They're finally TPing somebody back. I think they canceled the TP. They canceled FNG's TP. And there's still everybody in the base. Koyfa is going to work. The Ancient is now getting hit up. He's going to the best that he can. BZZ getting low as well. Iceberg has his BKB. They need to go home at
this
point.
Back.
Finally, people are starting to TP out. They buy back. Quickfoot keeps this game even for now. He's going to work. The right clicks. Iceberg will fall. He's going to have to buy back. BZZ will do the same. The well is so low. The Ancient is so low. Quickfoot gets out meanwhile. Everybody is buying back. I don't know what's happening.
He saved the game. That's actually insane. How do you hold off? Oh, now they're going to box in with the Darkseer. They're going to find
DK Phobos is going to die. The Hex is going to come through. The rest of his team is there. Vacuum back. He has buyback as well. Okay, Trixie needs to be careful. Oh,
Trixie,
I can't believe that.
That means now we've just spent, how many buybacks of the Dire? Two? Sven just used his again, so.
Well, the BKB last one coming out. And another kill here would be huge. They have the Omni Slash, the Wukong's command, they bring down the Sven, and all of a sudden, all that work might be for naught.
Oh, the lanes are so far out now,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, that might have been it.
Oh, they're going to get Megas now.
Yeah. And then at this point, I don't know where you go.
You have no hope. You have to try and go for a throne play.
Yeah, they're going to try to go for it, but already BZZ is TP back in. And here we go, Quickfoot now getting stunned up
they
as FNG goes to work, and that might be enough. He's going to do a lot of damage here, but it's not enough. And he's dead
but
for
Hani,
2 minutes.
Maybe?
Meanwhile, Hani going to work with the Desolator, but it's still not enough either.
No.
And that should be it, I think, Trent.
The dream is dead. Backdoor too strong, boys.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Good chance here. And there will be no buybacks for anybody if they die. But the Ancient getting hit up, it's already taking a fair bit of damage. They're going to come through the Blade Crew. They want this. The Static Storm comes out. They'll find Hani. Not really the best option. But now the Wukong's command, the stun comes out as well. Refresher, they want to get a double lasso off if they can. Vacuum, but no wall to follow up. And, well, they had, unfortunately, the lasso onto the Sven. And that will end the game. It is going to be Team Spirit taking the first victory here in this series. And one game away from making it to the Grand Finals. Trent, what a fantastic... Yeah, 5.2 regen is kind of insane. FNG looking for a Slithering Crush, getting auto attack down. Man, if he had Ignite, let me tell you, that's problematic.
I think he had to take the Fire Blast because the Slardar on top of Quick, but I think that's why he skilled it. But
Dual Breath, Trixie out of mana. He has enough to TP in about 5 seconds, and he'll probably do so to get to the tower. They do a Frostbite, though, and actually, this might be your first blood. There's the Frostbite, and Trixie's done. And so, much like yesterday, it continues. Meanwhile, FNG gets the kill onto Koigfa. Hani will pick up the kill on Iceberg, but the trade is much more favorable for Spirit now. So, all on top. And I don't blame them for being a bit more, you know, jungle heavy right now. But FNG has an invis rune now, so Koigfa needs to be a little careful. There is triple raise. He's almost level 2 raise. In fact, he's got it now.
Oh, yeah.
Double raise
timing
to come out. Should get this kill. Ooh, kind of misses there. One more auto attack. The Fire Blast, though, and Koigfa now trying to turn this around. The LSA, they turn it around, and Iceberg hesitating perhaps a half second too much.
Yeah, he canceled a low ground attack when he shouldn't have, and then he got an uphill miss.
He might actually die here. The Ignite is up. Koigfa coming back in. Dragon Slave should secure the kill, and it does. Not only that, FNG is back in, and looking for a turnaround. Oh, don't do it. No. LSA, nicely done. On to 2. They have the Dragon Slave coming out. No Laguna's level 4. Slithering Crush to fly through. Here comes Mizera Blade Illusions. Now they get the LSA again, and it's going to be Vanxcore dead. Trying to TP out FNG. What? That Dragon Slave was so close to getting that kill. Trying to leech. Well, he's only level 5. LSA will go. The Illuminate misses, which means that the skill's probably not going to happen. Although he has another LSA in 2 seconds, because guess what? Chakra Magic. And I think he's dead. And Hani, meanwhile, gets a kill elsewhere onto the Shadow Blade. They will finish off Era at the end of the day, and now they have the Frostbite on the Hani. So it's not that bad, actually, for Team Spirit. They have to find way more of these kills, though. But losing the Shadow Blade is pretty problematic, I will say, for Spirit. This is not up here. FNG's got another sprint in 3 seconds, another Slithering Crush in 2. Trixie doesn't have Ice Path. They do have the Dual Breath. They're going to chase after him instead of Era. Gera is probably the better kill, but it's a lot harder to bring him down. Trixie about to go down, and Rage comes out. Vanxcore taking some damage from Era, but should be the end of it. Vanxcore's going to head back home. Macro Pyre doesn't do enough damage, especially now that it's daytime. However, though, a smoke will come out from Team Spirit. FNG and Vanxcore will head across the river. Koigfa about to get sprinted on, and it looks like, well, he's in trouble. He doesn't have his LSA. Slithering Crush should go. LSA. Oh, no, they miss. They miss the Slithering Crush, and Koigfa is somehow fast enough. Body block.
He's running out of fiery stacks, though.
Here's some TPs coming in. LSA now hitting on to 2, or rather just the 1. Meanwhile, Vanxcore still alive. The Rage from Iceberg. The Dual Breath won't hit on the Vanxcore either. The Illuminate just misses as well. They will get FNG out of
turn
this. No. Now the Shrine Vex score. Is he actually going to survive here? Double Ray's coming out. No, just the single. DK Fobo's coming in. He's got that Void coming out. Double kill for Iceberg. What a turnaround fight. Quickfoot getting chased down, and they just don't have the heroes to save his life. Yes, Arrow is still farming top, but a good fight for Spirit to turn it around.
Vanscore is making me a believer in Crystal Nova again. If you watch Hani play lately, it's
Arrow doesn't have Sunder. Arrow. Overpower coming out. He's in some trouble right now. One more auto attack. BZZ gets a dominating spree. That's pretty big. That is a big kill.
Yeah, when you watch Hani lately, he skips the Crystal Nova and he just goes 0-2-3 and then into level 6. And then every time that he finds someone as Crystal Main, he'll just freeze and start ultiing. And it works really well. Never fun. It's good that he got his own.
They need
really
to leave
quickly,
now because there's an Observer Ward. They see something's coming and they need to get the hell out. Hani is going to be spotted. Fire Blast will come through. Enrage is back up. LSA comes out. I don't know about this. Trixie probably in some trouble. Earthshot coming out. Good LSA coming in. Blinding Light on top of it. Trixie somehow still alive. Dragon Slave. Vanksker running. Here comes the Void. Stun up onto
Trixie's
DK Phobos. Another LSA.
There.
They are really diving for this BZZ. You got the kill, buddy, but I don't know if it was worth it. Slinging Crush now. Doesn't have Enrage, or rather, he doesn't use it. Hani still one more auto attack. Awaits the Crystal Nova. That does the job. Raze is coming out. Aaron will die. Boogie now getting chased down. They are diving the tower. Good Blinding Light might stop this, but here comes DK Phobos.
Get the LSA off right from the Aegis.
Yeah.
Would have been very, very key, but he gets the Enrage.
Hani, don't do it.
Just runs.
Oh, God. Oh, and they dodged the LSA. That was a great Delta split. Did you see that?
Yeah,
one hits this way, the other one hits this way. That was pretty sick.
Man, they're making plays, dude.
Yeah, they really are. Oh, for
honestly.
Sure. Yeah.
You just
sure.
You don't buy eggs this game, I don't think.
Yeah,
well, maybe
you're
still
not, there's not going to be, there's going to be like maybe a minute or two. Oh, this Requiem. Quakefus, see you later. One good stick charge is not enough to keep him alive, unfortunately, and Iceberg is able to blow him away. Darkness, speaking of which, has been popped. And that means your vision is now drastically inferior to that of the rest of the team. Hani will try to bloodlust himself away, and Era is nearby. Meanwhile, down bottom, it looks like FNG was trying to get away from Boogie or vice versa.
Dude, it's actually terrifying when you go into Rainy Vision right now.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
it's not
they can't see anything.
Guna, DK Phobos, now in some trouble. The Silence will come out. Still alive. He's got stick charges. He'll use them. Two earn charges as well. He's pretty speedy, but here comes the Mana Leak. Blinding Light back into the Dragon Slave, which actually helps get the kill. And now you need to be careful if you are Team Spirit, but here comes BZZ jumping with a Blink Dagger, Earthshock, Overpower coming out, Freezing Field, Boogie is trying to run, it looks like he might make it away, the Glimmer Cape comes out. Now they're looking for Quake, a Slithering Crush should come through, they can't get it off in time. Instead it's the auto attack from Iceberg that won't take him down but get him low. A raise up onto Trixie, good, Ice Path, one more auto attack, he's alive and they get the kill. They still will lose Trixie in the end, meanwhile the Mana Leak is up, BZZ needs to be careful. No Aegis, he's got Blink in one, should be able to make it out. Meanwhile, they're still chasing the Seder Banisher. They get the purge off. He has the Sunder, mind you. Slurring Crush, LSA, Dragon Slave. What are they doing? Too aggressive. And all five will fall there. I'm not sure what the play was supposed to be, but that was definitely not it.
Yeah, very overconfident. That was, man, I can't believe Boogie just held that ward that entire fight, too. Those last two kills way at the end. There wasn't even, like, good chase in the Radiant. I don't know, but heavily punished.
Hey, Dangscore might die for this, too. Iceberg comes in with a Blink Dagger, Boogie. It was a good attempt with the Glimmer Cape, you're dead. Still chasing, FNG's got the sprint up, almost had his Blink Dagger, so. Broken, Earthshock misses wildly. FNG has another Blink stun at about 3 seconds. Doesn't want to get hit up with the Karn Jeremy. They'll smoke now, Era walking away. A double stun could be huge, Era's gonna be spotted. Slurring Crush will come out, can they bring him down? BZZ is not there. Frostblast, Metamorphosis, it might be time to back. The Requiem comes out, which will give some nice, you know, damage reduction, but that doesn't really matter.
FNG's still back there.
He wants to get this kill. He's going to get Quickfoot potentially. Good Blink stun. Meanwhile, they're chasing after poor Metamorphosis up Era, and it looks like he'll fall. Next is going to be a Frostbite onto Trixie. All of a sudden, Team Spirit,
dude,
they show, okay, listen, we were ready to go. Our stuns have been perfect. FNG has been owning. And they're going to find another Earthshock into Hani. All five dead. BZZ will find himself a double kill. And they say, forget about what just happened. We're fine. We're fine.
Dude, how does FNG... I mean, that was the nighttime vision. Because when you play against Night Stalker, you feel it's like the worst thing ever. But
You could see the vision advantage just straight up.
Yeah.
Iceberg, LSA, Dragon Slave, they shit up Laguna, I believe, but the Slurring Crush comes out, Iceberg somehow stays
FNG
alive.
Again.
Vanksgore pops the ultimate, Trixie is like, get me out of here, but he's done, and it's going to be four dead again, and Era might be that fifth. Another great turnaround, NIP slowly getting whittled away as BZZ will find himself a double kill, And Team Spirit are looking like they are in a dominant position at this point, Trent.
Well, it's worth noting there were like two games yesterday where, I would say both games, they were this far down on the side of NiP.
DK Bobos is when this game really probably ends, I would say. Darkness will come out. He's going to have vision of Hani, and Hani doesn't have vision of much because it's nighttime. Slytherin Crush comes in. LSA will stop at least a little bit of damage. Laguna Blade comes out. FNG somehow is still alive. Dual Breath will come through. Macro Fire, that should take him down, but they still will get the kill on Quakefa, and DK Phobos finds himself a double. Maybe he wants to go for the triple, but he needs to be careful as Era is there to provide backup, and he's actually getting hit by some Conjure images. He needs to be careful. Vang Score is nearby as well. Frost, Bite, Crystal Nova all available. His ultimate is up as well, so they don't really want to fight into that. And at this point, Era just, he can't really go that far out of the base in order to find farm. It's becoming very tough for him to find any room to work with.
Yep. So in the end, they're all dead.
Trixie, good force away, actually. The Aghanim's is going to spot out Quakefa. Quakefa's just like, he has an Aghanim scepter. That's great. I'm dead now, I think. Yep, Corrosive Haze, Era. Looks like they need a void, but they didn't have it. Just came off cooldown for DK Phobos, so they didn't have a Frostbite.
Shadow him. Make sure he can't get recalled or TP. In fact, he doesn't have TP for 25 seconds anyway.
I'm pretty sure he's dead here. Good tries on these jukes, but...
Yeah, there's no ulti for 15 seconds.
Requiem.
He has a Sunder.
God. All
right.
My God. Yeah, Sunder not going to work. It's just, that might be enough to stop
him. I think you at least use your BKB. I think you try and get a tier 3.
Oh, boy. Thanks for
that's
triple
a
Glimmer
Cape.
Iceberg popping to BKB Blinken. Requiem coming through, and it's going to come back as well. Already, they've lost the Ogre Magi. Boogie on the run. Trixie's low as well. Air is coming back to the fray, but it's already a little bit too late, it looks like, at least for that fight. They could maybe get something going here in a moment, but BZZ backing up in a way. DK Phobos and Iceberg, they're running in, jumping. Crush on to three, it looks like. They've got two kills, a double for Iceberg. They're going to find Era. All five will go down. Trixie will buy back, but there's not much they can do. Those are the last two buybacks they have currently. And Rage comes out from BZZ, avoiding all of that fire damage. The tier 3 tower will
get
fall.
A Sunder?
Go for it. Get him, Era.
Can we get one?
He might not. I don't think he wants to use it now. But
oh, here
jump
it is,
in,
guys.
Slytherin Crush. Gets forced out. You got Sunder if you need it. He's going to use it. Nope. Can't get it off in time. That sucks. However, Iceberg taking a good multicast to face. The Ice Path is out. They get the kill. A Death Requiem. BZZ needs to be careful as well. The Yule Scepter comes out. And uh-oh, maybe NIP. They might be getting these kills, and I think Team Spirit might have overextended. Yeah, BZZ will fall, dead for 76 seconds. DK Phobos forced to BKB himself, and it's now gone. Yule Scepter should be coming out. There's going to be the Void coming through. LSA doesn't connect. They can still chase down. They have the Fire Blast. The Glimmer Cape is there. Phobos is dead. Gem is dropped down. Quakefa finds a double kill, and now they're not done yet. FNG getting chased down. Trixie has the Yule Scepter. The Ice Path to follow up as well. The Liquid Fire is there. The LSA, the auto attacks from Alina. A triple kill for Quakefa, and they do not lose their racks. They only lose the Tier 3 tower.
All right. I mean, who needs aggressive force staff? So they're just going to chase you to your Iceberg. He has cheese.
He has cheese, but it's still coming out of his backpack. I think he might be fine. He's going to eat it momentarily. Boom. Cheese eaten. That's got to be so frustrating. Here, we're so close to getting that kill. Anamorphosis has popped, and all of a sudden, FNG is getting blown up. Now they're looking for BZZ. He has the Aegis, mind you. All right, the kiting is happening. Requiem is already gone. Now Quaver trying to get out. Laguna Blade has already been used. Yule Scepter. DK Phobos now getting caught as well. They're going to jump in. Slytherin Crush misses. All of a sudden, where is that CM ult? Iceberg will come in with a BKB. It doesn't matter. NIP, they just can't fight into all of these items and abilities and all that jazz. CM ult coming out. Glimmer Cape. They have to Sunder. Still, the Frostbite is up. Here comes the Overpower and Rage, and they will get the kill with Era in the well. And he's dead for 70 without buyback now. Slowed up on everybody.
Guys, the well again.
Don't do this. You got Rax. Get out. Oh, Laguna Blade actually just killed himself. That's hilarious. Bullet of Storm. Iceberg gets an ultra kill.
He's buying back at Botsic.
Slytherin Crush. Quakefa, he also bought back. But he is very low. And here comes Iceberg with two auto attacks. It's a rampage for Iceberg. He bought back. He wanted it. He got it.
Yeah, no, that's good. The buyback.
Era gets forced across the high ground. Slytherin Crush comes out, though, and here comes the Ursa. Earthshock is gone. Meanwhile, the Metamorphosis is there, but here comes the Freezing Field. They're going to try to force out. Meanwhile, Trixie's done. Requiem goes again as well, but 106 seconds for Trixie on the sidelines. Quakeful will Shadowblade away. If they can find Aero, it'd be huge. Good force out, but auto attacks from Iceberg. Going to some serious work. Vanskor jumps in, gets the Frostbite off. Crippling Fear coming out as well as the Void. Glimmer Cape keeps Aero alive for now. LSA stops him in their tracks under the Frostbite.
Oh, it's coming.
That long range Laguna Blade comes out. Now here comes BZZ. Three dead. It's going to be a potential fourth here as Boogie, he's trying to shrine, but the damage that Iceberg has is more than enough. Four dead. GG is called. Team Spirit are your second grand finalists along with Friends. And all CIS Affair and IP are done. And done in the semifinals. Well played, Command from Spirit here, Trent.
Yeah, very well done by Team Spirit. They, first game, very even, obviously, throughout the vast majority of it. It came down being pretty close to the end. But this one, they just took a total stranglehold of this game and choked out.